Hey, this will be a short yoga fly for activating our legs. It will have a grounding element, and as always, I invite you to participate as much or as little as you want to. Challenge yourself and rest whenever your body is asking for these things. We will move into a hands and knees position to start with. Hands are under the shoulders and knees are under the hips. We're going to make a few rounds of cat-cow breathing. So you're softening the elbows, lifting the crown of the head, and lifting the tailbone as you breathe in. As you breathe out, we're rounding the spine, chin to chest, tailbone down. So as you breathe in, our focus is on space in the front body. Allowing extra breath, and as we breathe out, we're using the shape of our body to press the breath out, rounding the spine, bringing the chin to the chest. Begin to find your yoga breath here, so you're slowing down your breath, slowing down the movement. This will be a slow, challenging flow. If we can keep our breath full and slow, this is very soothing and calming. And even in our more challenging movements, the body and mind can stay focused. So from here, you have the option to carry on with cat-cow breathing. Or as you inhale, you make that cow shape. Rock yourself backwards, hips move backwards, and as you breathe out, you're rounding your spine and coming up to your hands and knees in that cat position, arching your spine. Take another couple of these, following your own breath. Close your eyes, maybe, and slow it right down. From here, come back to your neutral table. Take a little lunge just to start to get into our legs. Keeping your breath flowing, we're keeping it smooth and deep. We're going to pick the right foot up, reach those right toes out behind you. Stay for an extra breath. We don't want to lift the foot up any higher than that hip. As you breathe out, bend the knee, draw the knee in towards your chest, and slide that foot all the way through. From here, you can keep your fingertips down. You can stay in this low lunge if you like. You can, if it feels good, begin to rock backwards and forwards a little bit. So you're just moving your hips backwards, lifting that front foot, and then rocking forwards. Maybe taking two or three of these. We're moving really slowly. And still breathing deeply. Next time you come forward, plant that front foot, reach your hands up, press down through your legs strongly. And as you breathe out, bring your hands all the way down to the floor. As you breathe in, tuck those back toes for some support, and then slide that right foot all the way back through, however you want to get it back there. The right toes point down towards the floor, lower them, and then you have the option to step back into a plank. Or lower down both knees into the table. Big breath in here. And then as you exhale, lower both knees now. You can shake out your wrists. Rock yourself side to side. If you're listening to your body like this, you're strengthening your body-mind connection. So let's go for the other side. Pick the left leg up. Reach those left toes back. Stabilize. And then bend the left knee. Into your chest and slide the left foot all the way through. So much you rock, how deep you go. Instead, just focus on a neutral spine. And next time your foot comes forward, plant it down, reach your hands up, and find that low crescent lunge, press down through your legs. Find power that lifts your upper body. As you breathe out, bring the hands down. As you breathe in, tuck those back toes. And then you have the option to slide that back foot all the way through and then poke it back out behind you. Neutral spine. Lower the left toes down. Lift the right knee up. Find your plank pose. Take a breath in. So your option here is to bend the knees, push the earth away from your face, and move back to a downward facing dog. If you would rather stay in a tabletop, please do. If you want to adjust once you're in your down dog, please do. We're looking to find a neutral spine, soft elbows. And you can really bend your knees and lift your heels, lifting your hips up high. We're actually almost doing a handstand in the upper body, trying to, stacking everything. Look back at your feet, lengthen the back of your neck, take one big breath in. As we breathe out, stay where you are, push through your hands and feet. As we breathe in, look forward, option to lower to your knees or to move forward into a plank. As we breathe out, bend those knees, come back, downward facing dog. One more time like that, you can round your spine if you like, get some space and find a bit of a wave. Or you can lower to your knees, and then on your exhale, push yourself back. Next big breath in, we'll pick the right foot up. Just like on hands and knees, you can reach those toes out behind you. As we practice this step through, if you would like to practice on hands and knees instead, that is an option. We're going to look forward, bend the right knee, draw it into the chest, move towards the plank, and then step the right foot up. So we're finding high lunge with the legs, the back knee is lifted, both knees are really bent. Front knee is over the top of the front ankle or a bit behind it. And then as you breathe in, reach your hands up for your high crescent lunge. As you breathe out, stable legs, lower your back knee towards the floor. It can hover or touch down. As you breathe in, lift the knee, lift your heart. As you breathe out, lower the back knee. As you breathe in, lift back. One more time, lower your back knee down. As you inhale, reach out, reach your fingers up. And as you exhale, bring the hands all the way down. You can frame your front foot. You can back off a little bit here with your hips and begin to straighten through your front leg. Making sure both feet are connected, the back heel can be lifted or you can bring the back heel down. Completely up to you. The hands can stay on the floor, you can bring them up onto the leg. And we want to keep a tiny little bend in this front leg. Finding this stretch, trying to relax around it. Move to the edge, and rather than clenching your jaw, see if you can relax your face. Find some softness. Take a breath in, option to lift up halfway, lengthen the spine. And as you breathe out, bring your hands down, push into the floor, round your spine, and use your right hip to slide your right foot back. Lengthen the back of your neck, shake it out. You can air this out if you want to, by inhaling, looking forward, moving into a plank. Bend the knees, come back to your downward facing dog. Let's go for the other side, pick your left foot up. You can reach those left toes away from you. And then bend the left knee, draw it in towards your chest, round your spine, step it all the way through. If the foot doesn't go all the way through, you can pick it up, place it between your hands. It doesn't matter how we get it there. Bend both knees, push down into the floor strongly. As you breathe in, slowly rise up. As you breathe out with strong legs, you have the option to lower the back knee. Inhale to come back to your lunge. Exhale to lower down. Inhale, come back up, lift through your fingers. One more time, lower down towards the floor. As you breathe in, push down through your feet, lift up through your chest. And as you breathe out, bring both hands all the way down to the floor. Frame this front foot. You can step that back foot in a little bit if that's what your body is asking for. You're going to keep this back heel lifted or lowered, completely up to you. Your front toes can be on the floor or pointing back up towards your face. Take a couple of breaths. Focus on trying to keep your spine long. So again, this isn't about how far down you go. Keep the knees soft, keep moving your hips back. And breathe deeply into whatever you can feel. We're not labeling sensations and trying to hold on to them and figure them out. Just let everything pass through. If you're being mindful, our body and mind will take what it needs. Push down into the floor, plant your hands, sliding back to down dog in our own way, using your left hip to guide you. As you breathe in, look forward, you can move into that plank. And as you breathe out, bend both knees, come back to your downward facing dog. Take a breath here. And we'll work through a little fly. Inhale to lift your right leg up. You can stack the hips, bend the knee if you want to, or keep the leg straight. As you breathe out, bend the knee, look forward, move slowly, bring that right foot all the way through. We're bending both knees here for a high lunge. Breathe in, bring your hands up into position. As you breathe out, begin to lean forward, all of the weight goes into your right leg. Maybe you can lift your left leg, maybe we can find a warrior three or an aeroplane. Balance is a funny thing, so try not to get frustrated if it's not happening for you today. With your next breath in, slowly rise all the way to stand. Can you draw that left knee up towards your chest? Squeeze it in. And then release the left leg down next to the right. Shake it out if you want to. Inhale to reach your hands up high. And exhale, fold, bend your knees, and take a slow dive down. In Uttanasana forward fold, we're just going as far forward as feels good. As you inhale, lengthen, lift yourself up halfway. Place your hands onto the floor or onto your legs. And as you exhale, fold. Next breath in, you can take a slow roll up if that feels good. Let your arms hang. Push the floor away with your feet. When you get to the top, lift your hands up high. Inhale. As you exhale, connect the palms and draw them down into your heart. Close your eyes or half close them and just take a moment. Then let's move again. Weight into the right foot, pick up your left heel. Left foot hovers maybe. And then maybe start to press it back behind you. Finding your aeroplane or warrior three variation. Bend in your standing leg. Keep breathing and then lower your back toes. Both knees bend deeply here. As you breathe in, reach your hands up.
As you breathe out, take one single dip. As you breathe in, lift back up. And as you breathe out, bring your hands all the way down to the floor. Breathe in, lift your hips up high, and use your right hip to pull the right foot back. As you breathe out, lower to both knees softly. Untuck the toes and either bring yourself into a child's pose, supported, or just sit back on your heels and close your eyes. Take a moment to feel and know that in your challenging sensations, we can find growth. Tune into them and allow your body to feel them completely. Let's move through for our final side. As we breathe in, reach the hands up. As we breathe out, reach them forward. Lean forward, bring yourself all the way into the tabletop. Breathe in, tuck your toes. And breathe out, push into the earth, find your downward facing dog. Next breath in, lift your left leg up. Stack the hip if you want to. As we breathe out, look forward, bring the left knee in towards your chest. See if you can step or place that foot at the top of the mat. So you're bending both knees as we inhale, slowly rise up. As you exhale, stay, relax your shoulders. One more breath in to lift your chest. And as we exhale, reach forward. Drop weight into that front leg and either stay here, building that strength, or lift your right heel up. Your arms are going to do what they can to help you balance. One big breath in. As you breathe out, bend the right knee, rise to stand. You can touch the foot down or keep it hovering. Maybe interlace the fingers around the front of the right knee and squeeze it in towards your chest. Lower the foot down. Take a big breath in. You can keep that lace and press your hands up towards the sky. And as you breathe out, forward fold. One single breath, lifting up halfway, lengthening the spine. As you exhale, fold down. As you inhale, begin to roll up slowly. You can let your head, your arms be weighting. From your face and then slide your back foot, sorry, your left foot to meet your right foot. Take a couple of breaths in your down dog and then look forward. We're going to sit down in the middle of the mat, so you can take a little hop, you can cross your feet, sending the left to the right to the left. It doesn't matter how we get here. We're going to sit in the middle of the mat, down towards the bottom, so your legs are in the bottom half. To keep some balance, we'll do a tiny little bit of core just to help us down onto the mat. So as you breathe in, lift your hands up, and as you breathe out, make sure you have space. Take a really slow roll down. You can keep breathing. Slow roll isn't there for you today, you can just hold on to your legs. And
take yourself backwards.
As soon as you get there, plant your feet down a bit wider than your hips, and then a little further away from your hips, so you can't reach down and touch them. Arms can come out by your sides, and then just rock your knees side to side. So both legs over to the right, up through the centre, and over to the left. Let this movement be slight. And the next time your legs fall over to the right, you can leave them there for a few breaths. You can turn your head in the opposite direction. And you have the option, keeping this right leg active, the right foot is flexed, to place the right ankle on the outside of the right knee. Keep space in your body, so don't worry about holding a rigid shape, and stay for one more big breath in. As you breathe out and cross, rock yourself over to the other side and take whichever option you'd like. You can stay as you are. You can take that cross, sending the left foot to the outside of the right leg. Notice where you feel sensation rather than trying to figure out what the sensation is. Apart from pain, which we avoid, everything else is kind of open for us to explore. Looking to our edge. You can hold onto your shins, or your ankles, or even your feet. You can press the hands and feet into each other, not so much that we're shaking, but enough for activation through the insides of the legs. Releasing deep stored tension can be difficult, and a good way to do it is to write over that tension. Our body won't hold on in the same way. Stay for an extra breath or two. And then slowly begin to release, bring the feet together. You can squeeze the legs in towards your chest one more time if you like. And then slide yourself into legs and arms straight, or feet planted and knees resting together. You can support yourself with blankets and cushions. Make sure your back body is comfortable. Tuck your chin to lengthen the back of your neck. Relax your legs.